you for Saha, and thanks for to the organizers that allowed me to be here today as chair of this track. I'm a researcher in the nanomedicine laboratory of the University Sacro Hospital Luigi Sacco in Milan, Italy. Here about 4 years ago, we set up this nanomedicine laboratory where we perform different preclinical studies on nanotechnology applied to medicine, focusing on breast cancer management, inflammatory bowel disease treatment, and also recently on the nanoformulation of drugs, in particular antiretroviral drugs, for the delivery of the blood-brain barrier. Now is a important challenge in HIV treatment is today the complete eradication of HIV. Although recent the new antiretroviral therapies are now able to suppress the HIV levels plasma under detectable values, this virus is able to retain and to persist and to replicate in some anatomical structure or biological structure that are so-called sanctuary sites for HIV. Among them, the central nervous system is one of the most important because the HIV in the brain and the central nervous system promote inflammatory escalation leading to neurodegeneration and responsible for different neurocognitive disorders of different grade and severity. In this context, the nanotechnologies have provided a great promise in the eradication of HIV from the surface, allowing the antiretroviral permeation penetration in the brain, increasing their penetration across the blood-brain barrier. So for our experimentation, we chose as proof of concept as model drugs, denfuvirtide. Denfuvirtide is a fusion inhibitor of 36 amino acids and of 4.5 kilodalton of dimension. And we chose this drug because of its unfavorable pharmacological profile. Its plasma half-life is of about 2 hours, but mainly because denfuvirtide is a very huge molecule, it is known that it is not fit to cross the DVD. So we conjugated denfuvirtide on the surface of this iron oxide nanoparticle coated with a PMA shell, so with an amphiphilic copolymeric coating. And we call this nanoparticle mutants. We characterize this nanoparticle in dimension, and this is important, here is important the dimension of the iron oxide core in water. And we found the hydrodynamic diameter of about 45 nanometers, and the zeta potential of about 30 millivolt nanometers. So, denfuvirtide and both the components of this nanocomplex, denfuvirtide and the nanoparticle, were labeled with the fluorescent codes to follow their fate and to perform the experiment. We performed in vitro and in vivo experiment. First of all, we set up in vitro model made of a collayer of rat brain microvascular endothelial cells and astrocytes cultured on transfer. After measuring the integrity of our system, by measuring the transfer endothelial resistance and the apparent permeability of a high dimension marker, dextran 4, so we found that we were able to produce a strongly tight barrier. And we also verified by electron microscopy that we JSON monolayer of Wikipedia says on the transfer, which was also able to produce well-structured type junctions. So with this model, with this little model, first of all, we perform a little task, by adding a fusor tide alone or conjugating with a nanoparticle in the upper side of the system, and after different kind of incubation, we collect the lower chamber and we measure the spectrophotometrically the fluorescence of the compound permeated across the barrier. This was the result that we obtained, is actually even important. The project to increase of the fluorescence of the tide, of the fusor tide, between 4 and 7 hours, and between 7 and 24 hours. And here, to put the percentage increase of the FITC related to nanoparticles. First of all, we observed that the nanocompensation of the fusor tide was able to induce a significant increase of its formation across the blue-gray barrier between 4 and 7 hours, but also between 7 to 24 hours of incubation. But surprisingly, we observed that the percentage increase of the fluorescence in the lower chamber of the FITC, the FITC level of meat, was much lower than that of the conjugate type in the same time step. So this first result suggests that probably the two components associated into the material cells during their formation across the layer. To better understand this aspect, I'm sorry because maybe you're comfortable, maybe you are not so good right here, but we observe the confocal microscopy during the tibial layer on an insert, and we also the other, the endothelial cells in the antecedent 31, and we found that, as expected, and fluorotide was not able to internalize, was not able to be internalized by the endothelial cells, but the conjugation of the fluorotide nanoparticles allowed it to enter the cells. Here is not visible, but you can see the red of the Alexa 4660 related to the peptide. But we also observe in the emerged images of the endothelial cells implicated in the presence of the fluorotide units, we found that the fluorescence signal of Alexa 4660 and of the FITC, they were mostly non-photometric, as also you can see also from this intensity signal plot related to one line covering the site of the cells. So we can say we confirmed that the two components of the nanocomplex some way were able to dissociate into the cell. Then we, after the in vivo experiment, so we injected the nanocomplex, or rather the three, or the nanocrugated and fusel type, into the J vein of the mice, and we dissected it after 1 hour of injection of the brain. We analyzed the fluorescence intensity of the Alexa 4660 fusor tide into the brain by an optical imaging fluorescence system. And we found that the conjugation of a fusor tide to the nanoparticle was able to increase its accumulation into the brain. Values of 9 different planes. And again, we wanted to determine if this increase of fluorescence was really due to a crossing of the blue-gray barrier by the drug, by the conjugated drug. And we found, it's not so here, it's not so visible, but the fluorescence of the capillary. These are cryosections of the brain. The capillary, the fluorescence of the fusor tide in the capillary was only slightly higher than that of the outer fluorescence of the non-treated mice, but the conjugation of the fusor tide in the Australian singer is one where we also we perform the double labeling of the phenotype but also of the particle. And here we found that we found the same that the phenotype was able to be internalized in the epithelial cells of the capillary, but only phenotype was able to diffuse to outside the boundaries of the vessels, while the component of nanoparticles remain restricted in the vessels. So confirming this dissociation of the two components during the formation across the endothelial layer. So the mechanism of dissociation has to be elucidated yet, we didn't perform studies in this sense, but we want to have an idea of where and how this ventricular can be dissociated by the nanoparticle, and also to determine the mechanism of internalization and trafficking of the nanoparticle into the endothelial cells. So we performed an electron microscopy investigation of nanoparticle trafficking into the endothelial cells. Here are you see in vitro experiments in endothelial cells cultured and insert. And after 4, 7, and 24 hours of incubation, and we found that after 4 hours of incubation, the nanoparticles were barely still outside the cells, but we also found nanoparticles free into the cytoplasm or compartmentalized in big cell particles. The lack of non invagination of the membrane and the presence of free nanoparticles in the cytoplasm suggested that physically the mechanism of internalization is a non-endocytotic mechanism. And we hypothesized that the amphiphilic component of the nanoparticle was responsible for a passive diffusion of the nanoparticle across the plasma membrane. And after 7 hours of incubation, most of the nanoparticles were dropped into these candles of light compartments, but still we can find nanoparticles into the cytoplasm to be then mainly driven into lysosome after 24 hours. So our hypothesis is that nanoparticles into these late candles of light compartments and the lysosome can be degraded. And in particular, we think that this DNA shell that is degraded, allowing the phenotype to release the cytosol and then be scraped by the both drug resistance protein present on the plasma membrane of the epithelium that can be released in the phenotype out of the cells. So, in conclusion, we found that the invasion of the phenotype is on the crocodile and offset of the phenotype of the phenotype and the nanoformulated phenotype penetrates into the endothelial cells where the phenotype dissociates and is directly and physically excreted outside the environment. And about the mechanism of dissociation, the mechanism of internalization is a fusion of the amphiphilic coating with the cell, and with me, and important is the collaboration with the NanoBioLab of the Department of Biotechnology and Biosciences of Milan Bicocca, where nanoparticle has been designed and produced for us. Therefore.
I don't know if we can have one question.
One question?
Any question? Yes, please.
How long in particles for repeating the blood-brain barrier?
How long? In vitro or in vivo?
Huh?
In vitro or in vivo, you say? Oh, in vivo? Oh, okay, this experiment has been performed for 1 hour post-injection. So I found that enfuvirtide was able only after only 1 hour to cross the BBB on the other side.
Retain there?
Oh, actually, in vivo, I don't know exactly. We only found these two experiments with 1 hour post of injection. So I also have preliminary results on 6 hours of incubation, and I still found all nanoparticles and the drugs in the brain vessels. We know, because we did it, that the plasma concentration of injected the drugs is almost the same, conjugated or free, in these mice is about 6 hours. After 6 hours, we cannot detect anymore the drugs into the blood. So it's important to observe that after 6 hours, this is retained into the vessels. But we don't know what happened later, actually. It's just to explain a mechanism, and then maybe it would be interesting too. Thank you.
Thank you. Now it is the formality of handing over the certificate of recognition of the speakers. May I request Dr. Vignesh Muthuvijayan to come? You can give it to him.
Can I give it?
Yes, I can give it to him. Please, come for him. Go ahead.
This side. It's for you.
May I request Dr. Robert Pola? So I can give it to you.
Thank you.
So, very good.